Welcome to God's Way YTVY. I'm Adolphina Shephard, and this is my co-host Thomas Knight's Templar.
Good evening, everyone.
We have an awesome show lined up for you as usual. We have a fabulous guest here, Ashyn Angel, psychic medium, who's not only as beautiful on the outside as she is on the inside. And our topic today is we're going to be talking about tarot cards and oracle cards. And there's so many different types and a lot of confusion around this, so we're going to clear it up. But first, Ashyn, why don't you tell us a little bit about yourself?
Well, I am a psychic and I'm a medium, and I do readings and I teach classes on how to do this for yourself, because I believe everyone's born with gifts. And you don't need a professional to give you a reading to get answers, because sometimes we need those answers in the moment, in the minute. Mm-hmm. And so I believe that it's important for us to help others to open their gifts as well. So I didn't always understand the terminology psychic and medium. I just believed in God and Jesus and the Holy Spirit, and that's how I viewed it. So,
and
but
and
here
the rest just came natural. How long ago was that when you first started?
Professionally, I was probably between 19 and 21 when I started working professionally in this.
So it was about 3 years ago.
That was quite a while, like 22 years ago.
Oh, come
ago.
On, that was funny, wasn't it?
It was funny. But I was very young when I had my first experience with spirit. And as a matter of fact, I was 3 years old. And Adolphina, we were talking about this earlier, and I was 3 years old and saw my angel under the car that I was hit by. I was hit by a car at 3 and saw my angel.
You were hit by a car at 3?
Yes.
Could you tell me what you were doing in the street?
Yeah, I ran out of my mom's hands. She wasn't running fast enough. Like, she wasn't walking fast enough for me, and I wanted to see my grandmother in the office. And so, you know how young kids go, and I was pulling at my mom and ran out into the street, and the man who owned the apartment complex backed up over me.
Oh, boy.
Oh, boy.
And I had a really big book. If you guys remember those Richard Scarry books, they were like real big. And he ran over this part of my body and ran over the book. The book took the most of the pressure. And because cars were not light back in 1974. Was anything broken or whatever?
There was nothing broken.
Wow.
See, that angel kept you safe.
It really did. So,
yeah.
But because of that experience, I never questioned if there was a God or if there was angels, because I knew
you
it for
know
myself.
It now.
Yeah.
It was either that or you worked for AAA.
You're right. So I always had intuitive messages. And in my church and where I was raised, I was able to share what I was getting, and it was accepted.
It wasn't
seen as psychic or a medium. It just was, you know, a movement of the Holy Spirit. So I could share what
right.
I was getting, and I was totally accepted in that.
You know, there really aren't that many churches like that. I personally had experiences with a church like that, which I just loved. And the pastor channeled the Holy Spirit and all of his ministers channeled, you know, and so it was really cool. And they also did laying on of the hands.
Yes, that's what we did.
They
in
did
our
healing.
Church.
Yeah, and so that was beyond me, because I had attended Lutheran and Catholic churches. Nada, nothing like that. You know, it's sacrosanct. If
our church was not quiet,
you know?
Yeah.
Our churches were.
I've seen priests do that in a charismatic mass. They just touch people, boom, they go down.
Yeah.
And everybody's praying like crazy. You know, everybody's going, you know, in the Holy Spirit, and then the priest just touches them and they.
You know, I was actually at a place where I witnessed that in person, and I was in line to have it done. I didn't feel a thing. So afterwards, you know, I'm saying, okay, how come I didn't fall down like all these other people, and, you know, and shake and do all this? Well, the answer was because I already have the Holy Spirit
with me.
So here I was feeling like, you know, wow, how come? Not me, you know, but it turns out I was blessed already.
Right.
Either that or your clothes were kryptonite. It was reflecting it, you know.
You know, so that's great, you know, and it's nice when you have, when you grow up safe in a area and with people who accept you for that, because so many of the people who are intuitive and have these gifts, instead of being blessed, people think, oh, there's no prophets left anymore, or prophetesses. But truly, those of the light, the channel, that's what they are, the prophetesses.
Right. Yeah. But I also thought that everything that I was seeing and feeling and getting, everyone else did too.
Right.
And, you know, because I was just a really, you know, a hyper kid, and I'm happy and running around. I'm thinking everybody else is seeing the people that I'm seeing in spirit, and they weren't even on this earth plane. And probably, you know, when you get to that 12, 13 years of age, you kind of start realizing that not everyone is seeing and feeling everything you are, and people question you. And I mean, I remember being really little and wanting to share Jesus with my friends in the neighborhood and talking to them about God. And I remember doing that at a very young age, like it was a natural thing to do. Yeah. And the kids all accepted it. But the parents didn't approve of me doing that, and I had to.
Well, and yet they probably claimed to be a good Christian. I bet they did, right?
I don't know, but you know what? I knew and understood.
Yeah. When you were struck by the car, what basically happened is that was your connection to your guardian angel.
Right.
That was there to let you know that you weren't going to die from that.
You're absolutely right.
And that was your connection that opened up the gateway for you to view them and hear them, see them,
absolutely.
And everything else like that. Sometimes it takes a traumatic experience.
I believe that 100%. You know,
to actually do that, make people who are normally part of the ego, part of the five senses, and don't feel, you know, they just go through life passing through it. You know, they figure it's a beginning, a middle, and an end, and you're done. You know what I mean? They don't know that there's work to be done.
That's so true. When I was young, the man that I saw under the cart didn't have wings, because not all angels appear with wings. And I kept asking my mom, where's the white man? And she thought it was the man who had hit me in the car.
Oh.
And I said, no, not him, not him. And I was really young, and I remember growing up continuing to ask where that person was, because I felt so good and so safe under that car. That, you know, we were talking about that. If that had been an exit point for me, I would have wanted to go with him and not be here anymore. Yeah. And as my mom pulled my legs out from underneath that car and pulled me out from under it, it's so loud here. It's so violent here. People think that, you know, it's loud and violent here. The other side is all peace and love, and it's just a different thing. So had that been an exit point at 3 years of age with not a broken bone in my body, I would have gladly gone. But I was in a Sunday school class, probably 6 or 7 years old, and Mrs. Brown was my teacher, and she was such
a
sweetheart.
Did she have a lovely daughter?
Yes, she did. She did. And
what's the song connotation? Come on.
That's true. You're right. But I remember she started talking about how angels sometimes appear without wings, and I said, that was my angel. And she looked directly at me and looked to the side, as if she was listening to someone invisible, turned back to me and said, yes, it was, honey. And I've never doubted ever after that. I've never gone through that wondering or wishing. Not physically like I did, but absolutely. That was my guardian angel. And I knew it then, and I know that this exists. And I didn't go through that time period where you question it. I went through the time period where I closed up and maybe got quiet.
Well, you know what, is society does that to you. Society, you know, that, you know, if you start being the one kid who can see things, and then you become, as the girls get to adolescent age and they start pairing off into little groups, you know, she's weird, spooky things happen around her.
That's why a lot of the kids today
that have the ability, keep it to themselves, because they're afraid of being ridiculed by their friends.
Well, that's why it's important that some people work with the children. And I actually know a couple of people who, that's their specific role, is to work with the children. And one of the things
that Carol does that.
Yeah, Carol does Tone. That. And my friend Luann does that too. She's starting to work with the children. And mostly gifted children like autism and Asperger's and those type of kids, you know, most of them are really high vibrating souls that came in to hold the light and so forth. So she's working with them, and I really think it's important to let kids know and encourage them to stay open with this.
Absolutely. And I was able to do that for my children. I have three kids, 23, 22, and 18. And I didn't push them in any direction, and I didn't encourage it. but I gave it a safe place to land. Like, mm-hmm. I allowed them to experience and go through what they needed to go through. And
well, do any of them have that gift or able to
all
do the
all three of them have the gift. Okay. My oldest has chosen to, like, close down because he was seeing so much physically, which I did when I was young. And it comes in very quickly. Yeah. When he turned 19, suddenly the lights came on in spirit world, and he could see physical as well as mm-hmm. well as I'm seeing you both
oh,
here.
Oh, wow.
So we helped him shut down. And my daughter is now doing readings like I am professionally.
Oh, wow.
And she's
oh,
22.
That's great.
And she's
you
about
have
the
to bring
AGI
her to
one.
One of the expos.
Oh, she would love
you
that.
You should have brought her
oh,
here.
Yeah, I know.
Yeah, yeah.
Should have brought her here.
Have
she's,
I met
she's
her? Reading right now. She's booked today, so.
Oh, yeah. Have I met her at
you
the
have.
One
it's
of the expos?
Kaylee. I think you've met her when
okay.
she's coming.
Kaylee or Haley?
Kaylee.
Kaylee.
Huh. You know, one of the things that I don't think most people know, but I have personally experienced, but I do believe that God comes in the form of someone at some point to test each and every one of us. And, you know, I'll tell you, I had a test I'll tell you about because I didn't realize it then. I realized it at the end of it. So I'm going to tell you about this experience because it was so unbelievable. I had had a really bad day. It was one of those days where everything went wrong. And I came out, and I think I had $22 in my wallet or something. And I decided I'm just going to go across the street and sit on the step there and figure out what to do. And so I was coming from a pharmacy. So meanwhile, this guy walks up to me. And he was a young man, maybe 22, 24, something like that. And you could tell, even though he was clean and everything, that he had been in a really bad fight. He was all banged up and bruised and cuts and stuff. And he came up to me, and he started telling me a story about how, you know, he had lost his wife and his kids because he got hooked on the drugs. And did I have any money because he really needed to catch this bus to this rehab center where he met somebody recently. And I was ready to poo-poo him, you know. And then suddenly something came to me, and I took out the last of the money I had, and I gave it to him.
You gave him $22?
Uh-huh. And he turned around, and he said, Will you bless me? Will you pray for me? And that was when I realized, and I said, in the name of the Father, and I said, oh my God, I have the power to do this. And that was a big surprise for me. Okay, so that was something. But then I turned around for a second, and when I looked back, he was totally gone. Just gone. And that was my test, and everybody gets it. So, you know what they say about beware of strangers because you may be entertaining angels?
Absolutely.
Well, I do believe that, you know, when you're dealing with people, you're in the public and stuff like that, I get those tests all the time where people would really try to get under my skin, mm-hmm. and I won't let them win, you know, and do that. If you go with the mindset that you are looking at the face of Jesus and everyone that you speak to, mm-hmm. then you can get around that.
Well, you know, I just thought he was another beggar, you know what I mean? But honestly, if he got on that bus, he got on a spirit bus because I turned, it was this quick, you know, and boom,
spirit
he was
in
gone.
The sky.
Oh, yeah, yeah, that was it, that was it.
Either that or he was at Aqueduct putting dumb money down on that trifecta, you know, but he was gone.
I know, it was really something, you know. So anyway, we have an assortment of cards here. Ashyn brought her cards, and I just thought it would be fun to show how many different decks they are. I have Egyptian cards here. I have dolphin cards and mermaid cards. I have Mother Mary cards, the Oracle cards, galactic cards. And this, as Ashyn called it, was this, like the starter deck, right?
Yeah,
for
is.
Learning how
it
to
is.
Do the deck. And you brought a bunch of them. You want to share what you brought?
Well, these are my two newest favorites. And they're illustrated by Josephine Wall. It's Whispers of Love and Nature's Whispers. And these are Oracle cards. And we should talk a little bit about the differences. And I also okay. have a couple of...
I was just going to ask you that.
I have a couple tarot decks on the other table, but they have a more... I want to bring a picture over. They have a more angelic energy. And in fact, the person who wrote these cards has done oracle cards for years. And mm-hmm. it's Doreen Virtue, and I love her. And she has had some beautiful... She did your mermaid deck there, too.
Yeah.
And... She was the first person that I read the book of and have the cards of. And when I started learning tarot, I said, I want her to put out one because She has such a high vibration and such a great energy. And I waited 15 years, but she came out with them. So she's got three decks now, and it's an angel tarot deck, and it has all love and light, and it's all high energy, and there's no, not that tarot has negative messages, but there's some imagery that people over the years has taken to mean something terrible. And so she's brought the deck into all love and light, and I love her deck.
You know, it's funny, we had a guest on the show some time ago, Angelo, and he painted Mother Mary. Well, I didn't realize it until tonight, but this fella, Tim, you may have seen him at some of the Expert, Timothy Flatt, he did the Mother Mary cards. He was another soul portrait artist, and he did these cards, and when I took them out just to look at them tonight to show Tom, I said, oh my God, they look just like the ones that Angelo painted. So it's funny
because they both seen the Blessed Mother.
Yeah,
and
yeah.
The depiction is the same.
Yeah, and just like the portrait that Christine had brought us of the Lord Jesus, and that Akinaya had painted, and that is the picture that she saw, as well as that little boy who made the movie and wrote the book, Heaven is for Real.
Heaven is for Real, yeah.
Yeah, they both identified Jesus from she painted it from when she had went to heaven in her relationship.
I saw that picture. Christine had given me, Christine Schiavone had given me a photo of that. And at first I thought she handed me Kenny Loggins when he was young. Because the hair was all back like an 80s haircut. And then I looked at it, I said, wow, that's Jesus.
Yeah. Yeah, you
know, and he's on the side of my bed.
And it's funny because I had already contacted her agent to see about getting her to come on the show, because she painted these when she was 4 or 5 years old.
Yeah,
you know, and now she's a she's an adult now. She's 18 now, I think.
I think she's even older than that. I'm not sure.
Maybe.
But Adolphina has a really beautiful, blessed gift. In fact, when you got that picture, that's the last time I was here.
Yeah, because
I got one too.
And I had right around that time printed out that picture myself, because that was when I was in contact with her agent for. And she might be on our show in the fall. It depends on when they come back from Australia.
Well, that day I had just posted that on my Facebook page.
Oh, how
that
funny.
Day, and came here, and she handed me the same picture.
Oh, how funny that is.
That's synchronicity.
Yeah.
It was to help me be not so nervous about being here for the first time.
You were, you were pretty nervous.
Yeah, I was. Well, you know, I know that, tell us the difference between the, I mean, you're the expert in this.
Okay.
I just play with them. So tell us the difference between the tarot and the oracle cards.
Okay, the difference between tarot and oracle is the tarot is more defined as far as how everything is set up. There's a certain amount of major arcana, and then you have the court cards with the minors, with like swords and pentacles, and that's where some of the people get kind of wrapped up into some of the imagery. And there's a particular way that you read tarot, and you set it up in a certain reading. When it comes to oracle, it's all about just pulling one. So like your Mother Mary oracle deck, pull one, and it will always be the right one, because whatever one you're drawn to is the right one. So oracle decks are great for people who are developing or who want to connect more with their angels or their guides or the Holy Spirit, because when you work with an oracle deck, every day you pick a card and read what it says. And depending on the oracle you've picked, like if there's Archangel ones, there's Mother Mary, it's a great way to connect outside of yourself. So you just pick out one. So go ahead, pick out one.
Yeah,
that's fine.
Like if
whatever
you
you're
this,
drawn to.
Yeah, I mean, I'm just going to.
There's no right way
like
or wrong way to
well,
do this.
I'm wearing turquoise, so I'm going to take out the turquoise. And. In all your names and all your forms, we honor you, including the Blessed Mother, Queen of Peace, Miriam, Our Lady of Guadalupe, Divine Mother of Humanity, Mother of Perpetual Help, and Queen of All Hearts, Black Madonna of, I don't know how to say that word, Chestachawa, maybe? Our Lady of Lourdes, Queen
Chestachawa.
Okay. Queen of Heaven and Earth, Our Lady of Immaculate Heart, Ave Maria, Merciful Comforter of the Sorrowful, Star of the Sea, Our Lady of Hope and Help, Our Lady of the Roses.
Can I see this picture?
What a blessing.
That's what
Thank you, Mother Mary.
Her down at the beach. I call her Star of the Sea.
Oh, it's all the names of Mary.
Yeah.
It's all the names of Mary.
So it's all her aspects.
And what that also is pointing to, that all the different religions, that, you know what I'm saying? It's all acceptance in this card. So it depends on, if you pulled your mermaids and dolphins, there's more, it's more about like things in your life or in that day. Mm-hmm. And you may pick a card that says, get more sleep, you know, or it may talk about something that's going on in your life. And it's just another way to connect. And oracle cards, there's no wrong way to work with them.
Yeah, because it has the message right on the card.
The other day when I sent you the song on the computer.
Yes. I love when you send me songs.
Well, I was.
He's a good singer.
I already know the next song I want him to sing me.
Well, I was singing this song, and my phone was ringing, and I'm looking at it, and I look down, and it says Fredo. Fredo was my best friend who passed away a year ago, and every time we went out, and we went out for karaoke or whatever it was, he made me sing My Way. So I immediately knew that he wanted me to sing My Way, which I did, and I recorded it. I call his wife and I send her a copy of the actual incoming call, and I sent her, you know, the song, and she said, you know, I said to him, you know, he's been validating his presence to her, and then I was drawn to do a card, you know, thing for him, and I, for some reason, he'd been telling me use six, three above, three below, and reading them as they're going. He was telling her, you know, that he's fine, everything's good, and he's with, as a matter of fact, he's with my Jack Russell. And I hear him from time to time, which is crazy, you know.
Aww.
So I know that that dog's in good shape.
Yeah, he's with know? Jack. Yeah,
there you go.
You know, but it was so wild that she was blown away.
So Ashyn is going to be doing some tarot card readings, and so I know we have a few volunteers in the audience, and so whenever, unless you wanted to say anything else or had anything else to add, we could start that pretty soon.
Okay.
What do you say? Oh, you know what? I wanted to say one thing. I completely forgot about this.
What?
Well, you know, my mother told me this, and then one day she came across an article she showed me. Now, this is going back many years, so I don't remember all the exact things, but I got the gist of it is that the tarot cards came about because they burned the books, okay, of all the ancient mystical knowledge. So
Gnostics.
What happened was, the artist and mystics put a story in each card. And a psychic, someone who is trained in that, or even just because they're a psychic, they can kind of look at it and know the whole essence of that story like this, of that particular card. And so, and then of course it developed more like we see it today, but someone who's very intuitive can look at that and get a few different options, but because they're intuitive, they know which one it is. So I found that fascinating because if you look at a card in depth, you will see many different things in there that you, if you just do a quick glance, you'll never notice.
That's true, but you know what's very interesting about Tarot is it also follows the life of Christ and Christianity. You'll see that in the major arcana as well. You'll see the crucifixion, you see the resurrection.
Oh, I didn't
all
know
of
that.
All these things are in the cards as well. So when people are like, these cards are evil, it's like, hold on a minute.
Right.
Because the story of Christ is in there too. And we know about the persecuted Christians. And so we believe that there's those types of things that have gone on like many, many, many hundreds of years ago. But that's all part of it. In fact, tarot kind of came about in a way of people doing readings, but originally it was part of a game, a card game that the royalty played, and then when the royalty went to bed or in another room, the servants would get together and try to pretend they knew how to play.
So they had the lower
arcana. But they knew how to give.
They had like the nine of clubs and stuff. They didn't have any good stuff.
They knew how to do readings, and they would use the cards to do that, and they would say, oh, this card means this. And it was really just a playing deck. But there are people who can use a regular
playing deck
to do readings as well.
Oh, yeah. I think they use it more as a focusing tool, you know, when they're just using the playing cards.
There's,
you know,
I have a girlfriend who actually reads them, and each one has a
specific
meaning.
Oh, okay.
And also, everyone is a different card in the deck, and there's books on that too.
Oh, you know, I haven't gotten that deeply into it. I mean, it is a vast subject, really.
Yeah, it really is.
You know, and that's why it's nice when we explore different subjects like this, so people can get an idea.
And I think what I want people to take from this show is that cards are just a tool. They're not your connection to the other side, your heart. You are the connection to the other side. And it's just a tool or a way to make you aware. Because if you keep pulling the same card and shuffling the deck and getting the same card again, you might have to pay attention to that. So it's just a way of you getting your own read, right? Yeah.
I did that, and I got, out of six cards, I got five in a row exactly like I did before, and I shuffled that deck.
Oh, that's funny.
Yep. I can't do that in Atlantic City, but I could do that here.
Right?
Anyway.
One of my girlfriends does that too, yeah.
Huh? Want to get her on this?
Yeah, you want to get started?
She's coming up.
And so while you get moved over there, we'll figure out who's coming up first.
We're going to have Hector come on. Who's going to come on?
Yeah, Hector. Who, you want to come, Hector, or he's on the phone? I don't think he hears us because he's got the headphones on.
Lisa, come.
Yeah.
All right. Yeah. Hector will go next.
Yeah.
State your name for the jury.
And we send an audience member every month. Is this in the right spot? Do I need to move this along, guys?
Can you hear her in the booth?
It's kind of pointing that way. They're not giving me the sign, so I guess I'm okay, Lisa. You know, when I do readings for people, especially with all the energy and all this going on, everybody's focused on us, it's nice for me to just hold the hand that you write with for just a second. So if I can hold the hand you write with, I'm just going to cue into your energy for a second. I don't know who's more nervous, you or me. Okay, so I have on my desk here some tarot cards, and I also have, I thought so.
There you go.
Very good. Okay, I have some oracle cards here, and I'm also, I have some tarot cards. So I'm going to grab a tarot deck, and usually we ask, what's the current question? Like, what is on your mind, if it's like work or relationships? Or we can just kind of see what comes up. It's totally up to you.
Yeah, we'll just see what comes up.
Okay. You know, before I even pull one card, I get the sense that you are a really lovely person inside and out. And maybe people take advantage of that at times. And are you still working at this time? Because I get an energy with you at work. And that... you're able to do everybody's job, but they want you to not allow everyone to kind of push you for what they need and allow you to have your own space, your own breaks, and your own time. So that's one thing that's coming up for you, and we're going to see if any of that comes out when I'm pulling cards for you as well. So I'm not really worried about where I'm coming from in this. I'm just kind of picking what comes through for me with her, because it is a tarot deck, but it's also made by a person who makes all oracles. So we can kind of just, I just pull until I feel led to stop. So money does come in, and that whole feeling of everything's in balance with money, that everything's coming in that you need. And it's going to continue that way. You may have to be careful about where we're switching money to. You know, you might say, maybe we're not going to do extra stuff this week because we're going to use it for this. But it's not a decrease in money, and there's no worry about money. It's about shifting it to different places. That's one thing that comes up for you. But we also have that, I'm getting with this card, it's like an energy of, like competing goals, like everybody has their goal and everybody has the things they want to do, and there's like a lot of irons in the fire and there's a lot of energy, and it's not necessarily you're having a conflict with someone else, but it's almost like there's conflict around you. So I don't know if this is still work related or in the home, but there's like a lot of high energy. Like I have young kids in the home, so there's always high energy there. So it's not negative per se, but it's just like competing goals. So everybody has what they need to do. Does that make sense?
We're a busy household.
Okay, there you go. The next thing that comes in is there may be a little delay in plans, like a little bit of a challenging information. And when I say challenging, it doesn't mean that it's a no or something's not going to happen for you. But it's, and you may already know this, there's a delay in something. So if it's with work, it would be a delay in a promotion or a delay in retiring or a delay in a vacation. There's something we have to wait for. And this is coming up in the near future. So this may not be something that's on your radar, or it may have already happened and spirit's letting you know. Don't worry, that it's just a delay. It doesn't mean it's not going to happen. In the positive, not the negative. The last two cards that come in, and I know we're on TV, so I want to be careful how I say it. It's nothing bad, but there's a sense of you being trapped by something, or that you overly focused on something, feeling that it could go negatively. Like you're focusing on it in a way that it could be that way. And it's a false sense. So what's coming in is that you have nothing to worry about. And you know what? I don't feel this is you. I feel this is someone, either it's a husband or a son or somebody else.
Both.
Does that make sense?
Both.
Okay. Thank you.
And right now, both.
It's a false sense. It's not realistic, and it's going to be okay. And what comes in with that is that don't give up. So instead of trying to reason with them, I want you to say to them, don't give up. It's going to be okay. Protect what you got right now and move forward. And kind of step back from it, because you could go on, and it's not going to convince them. And that's what's coming through for you. Do you have questions about anything that came up or anything you want to ask?
More about my husband and my son.
Okay. Is that what this came in with, that challenging information along with this? Okay. Well, is it that they're not seeing eye to eye too?
No, it's health issues.
Okay. Can I just say that Spirit doesn't say anything for nothing. So I do feel like there is going to be a point that they're not seeing eye to eye on this. So remember that I said it, okay? And they are saying a lot about not standing in the way of something. So I do feel like the two of them may really, you know, fathers and sons, they get along and everything's great, but sometimes they pick out something in each other and they want to correct it, or they want to say it. Mm-hmm. And so that's what I'm getting with this, and a big sense of you stepping out of the way. Now, that challenge that came in is that's that health challenge you were talking about. There's a delay with this.
There is, yeah.
But they're also saying that don't fear and don't bring any negativity into this, because it is going to be okay. But your mindset can really affect everything, even though it's a health issue that your mind didn't maybe create, is what you're seeing. Our minds can really affect our outcome with it. So I want you to stay very positive. And I think it's more about you stepping out of the way and saying, don't worry, we're not going to let this affect us, and step back from it. Does that help?
A little bit.
A little bit. Yeah. I think we need to talk more off camera
about
it, because, you know, some of these subjects are very sensitive, and we don't want to talk about everything right on the camera, because I'd like to talk to you more about that particular point after. But I want to do some encouraging here. And one of the things that's coming out is for you to communicate with your angels. Mm-hmm. So that means more prayer and more connecting in. And there's a trust card that comes out. There's something in this message for you that you may not be ready to believe and have the faith for. Spirit is really tapping in that everything's going to be okay when it comes to the whole health issue and other things that are coming along with that, and to really start communicating for yourself and to trust. And the last thing that comes in is that shield yourself, this last card. That's what we were seeing before about that. You're so sweet. You're so kind. You want to help. You want to be right there for both your husband and your son. But sometimes you can't be in the middle of that, and you have to give a little bit of space. And I think it's going to make a little more sense when time goes on.
Okay, thank you.
And we'll talk more at the end if you'd like to.
Thank you very much.
Thank you, sweetheart. God bless.
And who is our next contestant?
We're going to pull up the power tarot for you, buddy.
Oh, boy. I ate my spinach.
He had his spinach.
You had your spinach.
That's
he
what
said
he
power
said.
Cards. So I figured, you know.
All I see now is Popeyes. You have a lot of really high energy. You have a lot going on. We talked before you sat down. I said, please try not to think about more than one thing when you sit down, because you have a lot going on in your mind, even though it may not seem like it here. You have a lot of chatter that goes on in your head, and a lot of nervous energy sometimes in your head. You understand that?
Yeah, when you start talking about hearing voices in my head, that's when I start to worry.
You know, it's those who think they're crazy that aren't.
No, I'm okay. Just thinking about Russell. That's all that has the same voice.
What's your name again, honey?
Hector.
Hector, let me hold the hand you write with.
Sure.
Okay, take a deep breath and just relax. I can't read your mind. I can't read mine. Hector, you have such a strong energy. You're a strong person, and you are very sensitive. Also, you like to show your funny, fun side, but underneath it all, you have a beautiful strength about you, and you really care deeply about people. Make sense?
That makes sense.
You have to take a compliment. You have to learn how to take a compliment.
Okay.
Not just about your work, but about you. You have a lot of major arcana coming out. You know, remember how I talked about the tarot deck and having the major arcana and then having the minors? There's only, I'm on TV right now, so I'm blanking out, but I believe there's 24.
22 or 24.
And I've got three already, all three. There's another one, four, all major arcana, all of them. So what that means is that, I'm going to show you the deck here. I know you had that camera on me for a second there. They're all major arcana, all four of these, all four of them. So what that means is that this reading was predestined for you. You were meant to sit here and talk to me today, and you were meant to hear this. And it's also very important that I did say to you, turn off all the chatter so you can really focus in. And with four major arcana, this is super important for your life. You're really coming into a point where there's some big changes that are going to happen for you in a positive way. And it feels to me that you have to make the decision with that. And it's almost like you want to bring everybody with you and you want to make sure everybody's having a good time. And sometimes you have to focus on what Hector needs, what you need, what's important for you, no matter what anybody else says or feels about you. You know what I'm saying?
Yes.
Great. So the first thing that steps in for you is divine guidance. And this is Archangel Sandalphon. And Archangel Sandalphon is an angel that comes in with a very light, gentle energy. It's an understanding energy that says, I want you on your life path, but I'm not going to hit you over the head to get you there. That's the twin. That's Archangel Metatron. He wants you to get there and get there now. Mm-hmm. Archangel Sandalphon comes in with like a beautiful light energy, a very loving motherly type energy. And so this is a beautiful calling to you to search. You're searching for the meaning of life. You have to consider an alternate approach. Remember I said, I didn't even read this, but I said things are going to change for you. Mm. It's looking for that alternate approach and surrounding yourself and looking for wise people who want to help you. This is comes in with a very gentle, beautiful energy that says, Hector, you're here.
Is this one telling me to slow down a little bit, too?
That was me coming in with spirit telling you to slow down.
Oh, okay,
see,
slow
I
down
cue into it. My guides and angels, and I cue into my guides and angels have a conversation with your guides and angels. And anybody else, before you even sit here, my guides and angels are already talking to yours. And that's the way the Holy Spirit works. Mm-hmm. That's why I said this was predestined. They knew you were going to sit down and talk to me. And this is a real gentle, loving energy that says, it's your time, Hector. Mm-hmm. Let's do it. Yay. Not, what are you doing? Why aren't you doing it? It's more like, okay, you've made it here. Great. Now let's move forward. Mm-hmm. The next card that comes in for you, Hector, is a perspective card. See how that person's almost hanging upside down?
Mm-hmm.
If anybody wants to see that, it's like a... It's like hanging upside down. It doesn't mean you're getting hung upside down, but what it means is that you have to get a different perspective. So if you're about to embark on a new way of life for you, then you need to have a new perspective, a better way. The same way you've always done something, you need to go a different way to get there.
Mm-hmm. I have to change.
Change how you're doing something. So if we made it simple, we'd say, how you used to tie your shoes, let's find a new way to tie your shoes. It's not a big, huge change. It's almost like standing where you are right now. You don't have to do anything major to make this happen. But where you're standing in life right now, take a minute and look at it from a different perspective. Because when you do that, then you're open for the change and you can understand what's coming. Now, something else is coming in next, and that's a justice card. And this is Archangel Raguel, and this is a justice card. And this is about things being fair. Because I feel like, especially when you were younger, you felt like everything wasn't always fair. Mm-hmm. It's not fair, it's not fair. And I think if your mom was here or somebody who you was raised with would say, that's Hector. It's not fair, but it has to be fair.
Yeah.
And so that's the energy that's coming in now, is that part of you is going to fight for what's fair instead of just accepting what happens to you. You're going to say, no, this is not the way this works. Mm-hmm. This is the way it has to be. And standing up for yourself and for others instead mm-hmm. of accepting, well, what are you going to do? You're not going to say, well, what are you going to do anymore? You're going to say, well, what can I do?
Mm-hmm. So right? I'm a fighter then.
Yeah.
Told you that spinach hope.
There you go. No, what's beautiful is, isn't that crazy? The last card, can you see what that says? What does that say?
A very happy ending.
A very happy ending. It's the last card we're pulling. It's saying a very happy ending and everything coming full circle. All the things that you thought, why am I doing this? Why am I keep going over the same thing over and over again? Why is nothing changing? I'm trying so hard and nothing's really breaking free. This card is saying it's all coming full circle, Hector, and it's all going to happen. And I just want to know, what was your question? What do you want to know about?
The question that I wanted to know, which is, you remember how you said look in one, but it was two, and you answered two in one, which was one, will my area of where I live, will it be cleaned up, and my insides will be cleaned up, and also will I be successful and letting yeah. people change in my on my show and so forth.
And it's all right here.
See, so
it's all right one. Here.
2-1.
Wow. What does that say?
Yes.
It says yes. Yes.
Yes. Daniel Bryan.
Hallelujah. You know what's crazy about this card? Is I kept losing it. And I kept finding it everywhere, and I kept putting it back in my deck, and I kept finding it again. And the last time I found it, I said, I better put this in this deck because somebody's going to need to hear this word, yes. And it's the actual word I picked up.
Wow. That's a
that's
good
great.
Thing.
So I hope
wow.
that helped.
All right.
Yeah,
thank
that's
you.
Great.
Wow.
I think we have time for just one more. Where's the other lady? Lisa's mom. You call her.
We have a young one. How old are you, honey?
I just turned 15 2 weeks ago.
15, okay. So when I read for somebody who's very young, which I don't do often, okay, it's very important that I don't tell, what's your name?
Nick.
Nick. It's important that I don't tell Nick, this is the way it is, this is the way it isn't, because you know why?
Why?
You've got 100 choices in front of you, and they're all your choices.
Yeah.
So I'm going to give you a nice reading, a light reading, but we're not going to talk about life things for Nick because you get to choose. And sometimes when young ones come to a reader, if I said certain things, you would say, nope, I can't do that because that's not what Ashyn said. So we are going to be very careful with you. And we're going to, and that's why God asked me to bring these beautiful flower cards because they're all positive messages. So you need to sit up
Next
a little bit
up.
So they can see you and hear you, because this is your moment, right? Okay. So I'm sure your mom, grandmother, whoever the women are in your life would love me to tell you that the angels want you to keep your room clean.
Next
and they're going to want you to be kind to everyone around you and do your homework. But that's not in these cards. So, you know what's... Ah, there's some beautiful things coming up for you, honey. The first thing they're coming up with is shield yourself. You know, sometimes our friends and people that are around us influence us, and we have to be careful that we don't allow friends to influence us. You have to keep sitting up. They want you to sit up. Okay. Oh, boy, they're strict around here, huh? So, honey, the angels are coming in and saying to shield yourself. So that means that if friends aren't being kind, or you're being asked to do things that you shouldn't be doing, you gotta shield yourself and say no. Do you know what a shield yourself means? If you're holding a shield, what are you holding? Can you tell me?
I don't know.
Okay, so if you had armor on and you had a shield, would you hold it in your hand?
Oh yeah.
And a shield keeps you from getting hit by arrows or flaming things, right?
Yeah.
So this is your angels talking to you about shielding yourself. So if somebody starts to, you know, be angry at you or to tell you that you shouldn't be doing certain things or, you know, let's go do this bad thing, I want you to remember that the angels are saying to shield yourself and resist that. And you don't have to feel it here. You can keep a shield out Do you understand what I'm saying?
Yeah.
Okay, cool. Now, the next thing that comes up for you is this card that says Wise Soul. So I believe that we have many lives here on this earth plane. And some of us come in with more intelligence than others. And I want you to know that God's touching in to say that you're a wise soul. Like, you have deep intelligence. So you may not always fit in with all your friends all the time because you know more inside your mind. And that's about not necessarily school things, but about life. It's like an old soul. Do you know what I'm talking about, Adolphina? That old soul. You have a very wise soul, so stand in your truth with that. And the last one that's coming in for you, honey, is family harmony. Family harmony. And what that means is doing everything you can to keep everyone going smoothly. So if it's helping out a little bit by doing the dishes or putting the laundry in or not arguing with someone in the family, that's what that's about. Okay? All right, so.
That's a good angel.
You know what? We might actually have time for a 3-minute reading for the next person.
Okay.
Are you done?
Thank you so much, sweetheart.
Nice to meet you.
Nice to meet you, too.
Cat.
One more.
Yeah. One more.
Oh, come on. Come on up. It's your turn. I forget your name.
Lena.
Let me hold the hand your right way.
You don't know your sister's name?
Get out of our room. You're
fine.
Okay. Okay. I'm trying to think of where I want to go here, but I have the energy of somebody who passed away. I think they've passed away with me. And I think we should talk about that off camera.
Okay.
It's hard because, you know, I don't know whether to bring mediumship through on the camera or not. Ooh, action, confidence, and anticipation. I'm pulling from an oracle deck called Magical Times. And the first card that comes up for you is action. But I think you're all about action, Lena. Like, if you're like, if this is what I need to do, I'm going to go do everything I need to do.
Yes, I'm a doer.
But there's something you're hesitating on
mm-hmm.
that you're not doing. And that's what they're talking about. Because I know, I can feel your energy from the moment I met you. Like, she's a go-getter, right? You feel to do it, you know to do it, and you're going to go and you're going to do it. But they're saying there's something that you're hesitating on. Sometimes we don't always believe completely in ourselves, or there's something we think, oh, I don't know if I can do that. I don't know. But you believe it for everybody else. Like, you knew beyond a shadow of doubt I was going to be able to give you a good reading. But yet there's something for yourself that you're like, I don't know. So this is, isn't that a beautiful Pegasus?
Yes, it is.
It's a take action.
I want to show Pat the card. She loves
stop,
that.
Stop procrastinating.
Oh.
And look what comes right after that is that confidence. Be bold. Rise up and stand tall. And I know you're like, I'm a fiery person. I'm go-getter. But there is something that you're not. And maybe you don't want to talk about here, so.
Okay, so yeah, we'll talk about that after.
You know, I just talked about this card on my show. I have like a thing called Spirit Talk on Facebook.
Oh.
And if everybody's wondering, it's at www.facebook.com/Ashyn Angel. And I was just talking about this card this past weekend. It's anticipation. In fact, this might be today's card. Oh, I know what this is. This is tomorrow's. This is so.
I'm ahead of my time.
You are. This is tomorrow's. Sometimes we anticipate. And we anticipate negative things, and they want you to, whatever this is, focus only on the positive and anticipate the good things, because that's the big thing that's coming from you. I know I have like one more minute, so we're going to talk more when we're done here, because we have somebody that, oh, and you have an improving health.
Oh, that's good.
And you have, if you believe, remember that beautiful song by Mariah Carey and Whitney Houston, they sang that song, If You Believe. I want you to listen to this when you get home and hear all the words in it, because I think it's going to help you take action, have confidence, anticipate the positive, and improve health as well.
Thank you so much.
You're welcome, sweetheart.
Thank you.
Yay! That was great. Yeah.
Yes, you may return.
Yes, that was fabulous.
Come and sit hither.
Now people will actually know what a tarot card reading and reading is really all about, because there's so many people, because we're in this genre, we think everybody knows the same stuff we do, but you know what? They really don't.
They don't have
a
clue.
And there's a lot of fear. And they think I can mind read, you know, and, you know. There's some subjects that are taboo and I'm not going to talk about. Yeah, and, or it's going to be bad news. You're going to tell me bad news. I'm absolutely not going to do that. It's this spirit's never going to bring up anything that there's not an answer for.
True, that's true, yeah.
So if it's coming up, it's because there's an answer for it and there's something that you can actively do or pray for and wait, things like that.
So, you know, usually one of the things, if someone does come up with anything that strikes fear in your heart or scary, it's not of the light.
That's right.
So take it with a grain of salt. You got to go with your gut with this because, you know, there have been times when someone's told me something and it made me afraid. But you know what? It's full of baloney because it's
not
of
God.
Light. Yeah, fear is
fear
not of
is
God.
Fear is inverted faith. If you give in to fear, if you give in to worry, if you give in to envy, jealousy, these are all low energy events and they will drag you down into it and you will be a part of it. Everything will affect you negatively.
True.
All right, you reap what you sow. So stay out of that.
Yeah, but you know, just so people know, though, that if someone does tell them that stuff, you know, it's not of the light.
Yes,
you know,
there's lots of different readers out there, and it's important that people know. I'm never going to say you need a special bath for $2,000. I'm not going to tell you have a curse on your life. You need to give me 10 grand to get rid of it. Those are not things that are appropriate. That's not something a good reader should be saying.
You know,
to you.
Actually, I did have someone come when I had my Shepherd's Ark store. And I did some classes there and so forth. A woman came in, she was all panicked because she had a reading done and at another place. And they told her, you have a curse on you. You have to buy these candles and light this color, do this. And you gotta come back for some more sessions because it's gonna take me a while to get the curse off you.
Yep.
And it was just, she was so afraid. And that is just such the wrong thing to do, you know?
It's a pure crock of Genoa.
And it happens every day. And so it's important. So if you have friends or anybody that's saying this to you, let them know. That's not love and light. And I do wanna say one more thing is that I'm not infallible because I'm human.
Oh, of course.
So if you have a reading from someone and something just doesn't sit right, ask them the question, what did you mean by that? I'm not sure what that means, because they'll be happy to tell you what they meant. And also to know that God's the final judge with stuff. Mm-hmm. I'm not going to be perfect. I'm going to try.
Well, too.
Be an open, clear channel, but.
You know, but also another thing, too, that people don't understand, they'll say, well, she told me this and it didn't come true. So she's a fraud or something like that.
Right.
And what people don't understand, and I want to clear this matter up for them, is that, okay, you have a domino, right? Your life is a bunch of dominoes and at the slice of the pie, you know, your family, your friends, your work, whatever you're studying, your hobbies and so forth. Well, if one little domino changes, it can change everything.
Yes.
And this is what people don't understand. So hence, if someone said this was going to change and this was going to happen, but it didn't, then that's why, because something else changed. It changed the whole situation.
Right. Well, we are getting close.
Yeah, I guess we have to start wrapping up as much as we don't want to.
And we could talk all night about this, right? Oh,
yes.
I know.
Well, they'll throw us out of the studio henceforth.
Yes.
Anyway, let's thank our sponsors.
Yeah, we want to thank our sponsors.
Oh, we have more time.
And of course you, Ashyn,
thank you.
Because we all enjoy that. And for those who have never seen a live reading, I mean, it is getting more exposure with what's her name? Teresa somebody or other?
Teresa Caputo.
Dr. Oz. It's becoming more aware that these things are for real and they're not made up. You know what I mean? And so, but it's nice because there's not very, this makes it more common for the masses to see that this is real and if it's of the light, it's from God.
That's right.
Yeah. So, you know, that's why I'm always so happy to have on guests like yourself who are of the light.
Thank you.
You're welcome. I wouldn't have anybody of the dark on here anyway.
You know. Good to know.
Yeah. Oh,
you gotta
God.
You
got
somebody in a black hood?
You know, you'd be surprised.
Over here.
No.
Yeah, they don't dress the part. It's more like wolves in sheep's clothing. You know, that's where you gotta use your own discernment.
That's right. They don't come in as darkness. It's gonna come in as light.
Right.
Okay. All right, now let's wrap it up.
Okay. So we want to thank our audience here and our volunteers who were so gracious to come up here and
our facilities here at Time Warner.
And the facilities.
All right, and CTV. And our sponsors for our food and our meals for our staff, Antonio's Pork Store in Tottenville, and our other sponsors, Avoc Pest Control in Great Kills. Anything else?
Well, yeah, I want to talk to Ashyn about some other time she'll come on. I was actually thinking at some point, and we were talking about this, right, that Ashyn come on with maybe one or two other intuitives and do like a gallery reading type
thing. It'd be like The View, only did the psychics.
Yeah. You know, I mean, but it would be fun because, you know, when you have your guest and they can usually pick out a person where the energy's coming from and be able to give them that information. So some other time we'll have you on to do that. So, you know, I think that would be a lot of fun too.
That sounds like fun time.
Yeah.
Okay.
So
any last minute message for anybody?
Yeah.
Keep positive. It's your energy that's going to keep you well, happy, focused, driven, and to have that best outcome.
That's it. So agreed. I guess that's it. Yeah. I guess that's it. It's time to say goodnight.
Good night, everyone.
Everybody. So, we might have another minute left, they're telling us now. You know, it's like eeny, meeny, miny, moe, you know.
I do want to say this, that no matter what a reading says, it's still your choice. Nothing's out of your realm. It's always your choice. It's
That's
not
right.
someone else making you do anything. So choose wisely.
Well, yeah, this is the realm of basically, it's the realm of possibilities.
Yeah.
It's the realm of possibilities in what you decide you want to go forward towards, you know. If you have 10 different paths, you can choose, and they're open to you, you know, you can choose which one of those 10 to go on.
Yes, I was just talking to a lady outside the show before we got here in this, and that was one of the things. You have three choices, and you can go any way you want.
And Hector was talking about that, too. Two different choices, right, or something like that?
Mm-hmm.
Yep. So, well, now we really are out of time. So we're going to say God bless and good night, and we'll see you next time.
Till next time.
Bye.
We're going to do We
Bye-bye.
Are
the
World.
You going to sing it?
No, I'm not going to sing it.
That's what we need to do, is get him to sing.
Mm-hmm.
I wanted to do a show with that, and he's been poo-pooing that.
Well, I'll sing with you.
I know.